Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. Today's video, we are going to be diving into an app that's been around for a little bit of time now. It's called RemNote, and it is an application much like Obsidian and Rome Research, allowing you to create this interconnected note-taking system of bidirectional links. However, it's got a bit of a different approach to it in the fact that it's more tailored towards students. The different or special feature that makes it more tailored for students is not only the linking, but something called smart flashcards, which helps you use spaced repetition. Now, this isn't going to be a video where I show you the full in-depth ways of using RemNote, Rem Research. However, I'm going to show you more about the where it's available to download pricing and a bit of a tour around the application. I'm going to include some videos into some great getting started guides from the likes of Red Gregory and a few more other creators here on YouTube. So this month's sponsor is Woven. It is great to have them back as a sponsor. If you don't know what Woven is, it's a powerful calendar and scheduling application. It's actually my go-to calendar application and helps me schedule the majority of my meetings. Features include the likes of scheduling tools to be able to organize those meetings, whether they're group ones or individual, multi-calendar support, video conferencing for connecting apps like Zoom, and templates for saving you time with those routine meetings. You can get Woven for free in the description below and check out more. A huge thanks to Woven for coming on as a sponsor. So this is the website as we kick things off, and you've got a few great use cases here. As you can see here, some people are already using the ways that the block references are set up to create a really advanced setups for connecting different PDFs, different images, and different files together inside of their RemNote account for studying. So if I go over to download, you can download it on a range of different devices, Windows, Linux, Mac for the desktop editions, mobile, and they've got a RemNote clipper. Now, to be fair, that's not a bad little sort of lineup. It doesn't have an iOS application, which is the only shame. So looking at pricing, they've got a pretty decent pricing set up. So the free account obviously gives you the way that you can create bidirectional links and settle casting, and you can also turn notes into flashcards and that sort of general wiki. And I don't believe there's any specific run out of space. However, in the free account, you don't get the graph view, aliases, search portals, and some of the more advanced stuff when it comes to, say, PDF upload, custom date formats, and much more, like, you know, backup support, things like that that you'd expect. However, there is a pro version that gives you access to all of that, including the graph view. We won't be demonstrating that today. However, it gives you the graph view and all of the features, early access to new features. And there is even a £300 license, which is a one-off. And of course, you get the lifetime desktop pro, as well as 5 years of cloud support, which isn't too bad if you were, say, really invested in this application for a long time period. Okay, so here we are on RemNote. This is the web version. As you can see here, you've got a bit of a dropout bar. You can make that fixed if you want, but there are sort of two key areas to this. There's queue, which is a queue for all of your flashcards that you create from any of your notes, and documents, which is essentially your notes that you've created. And as you can see here, you can create a range of different types of documents, one being a regular document, one being today's document, which could be associated to today, and also new folder as well, and quick add, which I believe should just give you sort of a quick note addition. And you've got sort of three categories here: pin, draft, and finish. Let's go ahead and create a brand new document. So what I really like on this right hand side is you get a tour. So if you want to follow the sort of guide here, then you can. And one thing that I think is really nice inside of RemNote that I haven't seen inside of other applications is that you can add a PDF and it comes in line quite nicely. Although applications like Evernote do this, if you wanted to, say, have some sort of bidirectional linking and you understood it as a student or a researcher and you wanted to be able to connect up a PDF that already exists inside of your system, could be a presentation or it could be a document, then you can connect that up with the pro account, and that's quite nice, a nice addition. So as you can see, you can give it a title, and these little dot things are called rems, and this is quite a nice, like, sort of concept in terms of the naming. You essentially create a rem, and from the rem you can produce new pages and create links as well. So let me demonstrate how to create a page and then how to create a link to that page or a block reference. So as you can see here, if I actually click this little dot, it turns into a page itself. And as you can imagine, you can use the breadcrumbs to get back to it, and you can use the actual page itself to start writing away. Very similar to applications like Dynalist and Workflowy, in very similar concepts as well to Rome Research. Now the real magic as well is, say for example, I went to this page and say added something that might be useful in terms of, I don't know, a bit of study, let me add something, let me bring something up. Just a little bit of science there for you guys. If I went down here and I were to use the two brackets that you would traditionally use inside of a bidirectional linking application, and I were to type, say, nucleus, because it was on the topic of nucleus that I was writing about, maybe it's on a different page, I can bring in that block reference and it brings it in quite nicely there. So what's really cool is I can click into this, I can even open the graph view inside of the Pro account, and I can open that rem as a document. In this case, I'm going to go in and find that original note, and as you can see here, I have a link reference here, and I can, in the Pro account, use a search portal to list these results, which is quite cool. So from here, I can actually do a few things. I can do some more advanced highlighting, add a portal for it. I can even add tags, copy the reference, copy the portal to this rem. So as you can imagine, in order to create a flashcard, you need a question to get that flashcard going. So in this case, I'm going to add a question before the atom reference here. Okay, so when I go ahead and practice this, you can see that because I added this sort of question mark and then the two colons after it, it essentially allowed me to create a question and also an answer. So as you can see, it's blurred out this one. I can fill in the blanks here, and if I want to, obviously the answer comes up here. Now I can do a range of different things. I can disable it. I can just add this rem to an edit later document. I can accidentally press short, show too early. So for example, there's a range of different things you can do to react to that in terms of how well it was impacting on your recall or whether you made a mistake, which is quite cool. So for example, if I wanted to say flip the order, that might be helpful for next time. So for example, if I wanted to say that was quite hard, you can get a little bit of or sort of feedback on that one. And when it comes to next time, it will bring that up in a bit of a different sequence to help you to improve your learning. And what's quite nice as well is if you wanted to move on and find like another folder that you wanted to work on, you could go and go to this folder icon and choose a specific document or folder to study. So that's quite nice in terms of producing some really useful flashcards that get you going. So I really like this whole concept of being able to sort of create documents and be able to take more advantage of them. So from a free perspective, this is a really decent application. From what I'm aware of, it's got no limitations in terms of how much you can add to the document, which for some people can be quite scary. However, having that sort of digital backup, the cloud backup, which is available through the web version, of course, with the other versions, and having that sort of ability to create a flashcard really adds a layer that, say, Obsidian might not be suitable more so for. For example, if you're someone that really does just like very basic bidirectional linking and you're in research or study and you also want to be able to use flashcards, this is quite a cool application for that, and something that might be a little bit easier to comprehend and understand than, say, more of these Rome Research and the Obsidian applications that are out there. So guys, I hoped you enjoyed today's video. This was a really brief overview. I'll probably be playing around with it a lot more, maybe potentially making a short course on it in the next couple of weeks. This was very much my first impressions. It's a really cool looking application for study students who are interested in really being able to create flashcards out of their work and be able to make up some really nice bidirectional linking. And this is only the free version, which I was fairly impressed with. So what I would say, guys, is definitely check out all the stuff in the link in the description. We've got an interview with the founders that is going to come up a few hours after this, or maybe an hour after this. So if you did want to get to know the people behind this application, then that's something that you can do from that video. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I give RemNote a 7. Early days still, but I think this application is really well positioned, and the way that they're sort of adding new additions is a good experience. And I want to get my teeth stuck more into this application in terms of what it can really do in terms of the punch that it can offer. But guys, I hope you enjoy today's video. Make sure you're subscribed, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.